Hello, procrastinators! Back in the 90s, getting gaming news was a difficult thing. You had three basic options. Number one, just hang around in Electronics Boutique and see what was new in, but never know if it was any good. Two, you could buy a magazine, which cost about 10 years worth of pocket money each, but sometimes came with demo discs of games you couldn't then buy because you'd spent all of your money on the fucking magazine. Or three, you could watch Games Master.
Games Master, I'm stuck in the first level of Murray who lost levels. Can you help me, please?
A pitiful plea there.
TV and video games, man, why can't they just get along? Games Master, the UK's first entry into the idea of mixing video games and TV, was... But what's the nice way of putting this? Crap even for its time? It was a mix of slight gaming news, a few cheats for games you didn't play, and lots of crap challenges. Episode 2's climax is, can this random boy beat a level of Lemmings? And the answer was no. Still, like every single person my age, I watched it every fucking week, slightly because I was terrified that the giant four-headed Patrick Moore was gonna eat me if I didn't, but mostly because there just wasn't anywhere else to get gaming news from. Nowadays, we're drowning in it. I'm currently making it. And the days of video games needing TV are long, long gone. So anyway, I mentioned this because Games Master is back with the giant four-headed Trevor McDonald this time, and it's going to prove, once again, that video games and TV just don't go. Okay, that's a lie. One time they did go. Video Game Nation, which was great back in 2015-ish. It was a weekly show focusing on one game per episode with a cast of people who really liked video games, but you've never heard of it, and that's why it's not on the telly anymore. But anyway, new Games Master. The trailer has dubstep in it. It has a kid wearing a boxing outfit complete with gold chain and has no hint that there's going to be any reviews or news at all in the show this time around. I give it 3 episodes, mostly because it's on E4 and I don't even know what that is. Nobody wants to watch other people play video games. Wait, that's my career. I'll rephrase it. Nobody wants to watch celebrities be bad at video games or children. Well, do anything, really. You know what? Pitch time. Here's how I think you should make a video game TV show in the year 2021. BBC Two, 10 p.m, probably a Thursday night. Some light jazz fades in, piano heavy. We're in a warm lounge, a fireplace crackling away in the distance. In a comfortable chair, wearing a suit, no tie, is Henry Cavill. Hello, he says, the ice in his drink clinking slightly as he beckons you closer. You sit, and for the next 30 minutes, he talks about video games, cutting away occasionally to exclusive AAA footage and trailers, as well as a decent helping of indie games mixed in. Run it for 6 episodes every 6 months, and make the reveals good enough to make it feel like an event. The show becomes the place to see reveals outside of E3, and the star power brings in the casual audience. And you don't have to watch Vernon Kay lose Mario Kart against a fucking TikTok dog. I mean, kids won't watch it, but kids are too busy trying to fix the climate to watch TV anyway. Everyone's a winner. BBC, call me. Right, gaming news. Headline of the week is, holy fucking shit, how good does Elden Ring look? The almost 20-minute preview of it showed off exactly what kind of game it is, and that game is Death of the Wild. That long shot of the castle fading into a gorgeous map reveal that shows off that that's just a fraction of the playable area? Holy shit. This is what a day one buy looks like in my books. But my favourite part, was it the big dragon? No. The treasure cart being pulled by giant creatures? No. Leaping between the roofs of a castle? No invisible walls in sight? No. It was a small moment where, after jumping down several tall ledges, a door leading to a dungeon was found by the player. It's in such a nothingy area, utterly obscured by shadow, and yet it opens into this huge dungeon. And that's what excited me about Elden Ring. It's how much of it I'll never ever find. It's got Skyrim vibes, and on the Skyrim vibes note, Skyrim has been ported to another system. Cardboard, with the reveal this week that Skyrim, the adventure game, which is a board game, is coming out. Which I'm probably going to get because Fallout the board game is my favourite board game. Seriously, I've spent hours combing the semi-random boards, completing quests for ghouls, rooting around ruins for caps, and getting my tits absolutely slapped off by Deathclaws. It's a game that puts fun first, and admittedly, until the recent co-op expansion, we always ignored the majority of the actual progression while playing it. And although Skyrim, the board game, the adventure game, the board game, is by a different company, it looks to be in that adventure vein. So I'm genuinely hyped for its release in, let me just check, August 2022. Why do board games take a billion years to make? Bah! And speaking of ad segue here, GTA San Andreas is coming to VR, specifically one Facebook headset, and fuck you if you don't have it. If you want to know what it would feel like to shoot up a Duplo neighborhood, then this'll be the game for you. Oh, and also, remember how Rockstar said that San Andreas was coming to Game Pass? Yeah, well, it's not coming to Game Pass on PC. When asked about this, a spokesperson from Rockstar said, next week, we've got a few big releases. Forza Horizon 5, which is on Game Pass, Jurassic World Evolution Don't Buy Raptors 2, and Shin Megami Persona Wingardium Leviosa 5, all within a few days of each other. Something for everyone. Oh, and Doctor Who continues, which means that Mike Bithell and I are talking about everything but it in our originally unironically titled podcast, Fuck Yeah Doctor Who. The first episode of this series was 2.5 hours long. Send help, please. Send help. I think I'm dooming a friendship. Anyway, that's all from me. I have some happy homes to design. Bye. You know what? Pitch time. Here's how I think you should make a video game TV show. Did you just drop a ball behind me? Why, when I'm doing the show, do you come out? No, I'm keeping it. Confiscated. Yeah, you look sad. Fuck you.